In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Today we offer this Holy Mass for Frank Lasak. Brothers and sisters, let us prepare for this sacred celebration. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who teach us that you abide in hearts that are just and true, grant that we may be so fashioned by your grace as to become a dwelling place into you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Offering he did not. Cain greatly resented this and was crestfallen. So the Lord said to Cain, "Why are you so resentful and crestfallen? If you do well, you can hold up your head, but if not, sin is a demon lurking at the door. His urge is toward you, yet you can be his master." Cain said to his brother Abel, "Let us go out in the field." When they were in the field, Cain attacked his brother Abel and killed him. Then the Lord asked Cain, "Where is your brother Abel?" He answered, "I do not know. Am I my brother's keeper?" The Lord then said, "What have you done? Listen, your brother's blood cries out to me from the soil. Therefore, you shall be banned from the soil that opened its mouth to receive your brother's blood from your hand. If you till the soil, it shall no longer give you its produce. You shall become a restless wanderer on the earth." Cain said to the Lord, "My punishment is too great to bear. Since you have now banished me from the soil, and I must avoid your presence and become a restless wanderer on the earth, anyone may kill me at sight." "Not so," the Lord said to him. "If anyone kills Cain, Cain shall be avenged sevenfold." So the Lord put a mark on Cain, lest anyone should kill him at sight. Adam again had relations with his wife, and she gave birth to a son whom she called Seth. "God has granted me more offspring in place of Abel," she said, "because Cain slew him." The word of the Lord. Offer to God a sacrifice of praise. God the Lord has spoken and summoned the earth from the rising of the sun to its setting. Not for your sacrifices do I rebuke you, for your burnt offerings are before me always. Why do you recite my statutes and profess my covenant with your mouth, though you hate discipline and cast my words behind you? You sit speaking against your brother, against your mother's son, you spread rumors. When you do these things, shall I be deaf to it? Or do you think that I am like yourself? I will correct you by drawing them up before your eyes. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. I am the way and the truth and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The Pharisees came forward and began to argue with Jesus, seeking from him a sign from heaven to test him. He sighed from the depth of his spirit and said, "Why does this generation seek a sign? Amen, I say to you, no sign will be given to this generation." Then he left them, got into the boat again, and went off to the other shore. The Gospel of the Lord. Why does this generation seek a sign? Jesus is the sign for us, for our salvation. We don't need more signs. The crucifixion of Jesus Christ is the great signal for our salvation, the great sign of the presence of God in our lives. After the original sins, enter more sins, as we can see in today's first reading. Personal sins appear, and immediately God prepared the plan of salvation for us. In that plan, the great signal is the incarnation, death, and resurrection of his sons for us. We need more signals. When we contemplate Jesus Christ on the cross, we need more. That the Son of God died for you. The Son of God offered his life for your salvation. If we don't believe before the crucifixion of Jesus Christ, we don't believe before other things. That is the point. And for that reason, Jesus is sad in this passage of the Gospel. Tenderness appeared because he tried to show that people, to show us, his love, his mercy, his presence, and also he found bad answers, angry. They tested him. Today, we tested God too in our society. Where is God? Why exists evil? Why this pandemic? We tested God every day. And Jesus respond to us with his presence. His presence in our life, in the sacraments, his presence in the church. Come to me. Come to me and contemplate the miracle of my love. In today's Psalms, we pray, Offer to God a sacrifice of praise. God is real. God exists. And before Him, adoration, confidence, trust. When you open your heart just to your fears, it's impossible to have a good faith in Jesus. He is the great signal. Your life is a great signal, a great miracle. God exists. God loves you. And God wants that one day we will enter in His presence forever and ever. This is our last goal, the eternal life with Him. When appear doubts in your mind, in your heart, look at the crucified, and you found answers in that mystery. We don't receive more signs. He is the great signs for us, for our salvation. Jesus is present. And when we cross difficult moments in our personal life, in our history, look at the crucified and you found answers. You found peace because He died for your salvation. Let us pray in silence. With confidence and humility, we present our petitions to God.
For our Holy Father, our bishops and priests, and all the people of God, that we may never test the Lord, but obey Him with faith and love, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace, that the slaying of our brothers and sisters may cease upon the earth, and that the murderers may repent and turn back to God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For mothers distressed by the evil actions of their children, for mothers whose children have died untimely deaths, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick who have been recommended to our prayers, and for all those who are most forgotten and who must suffer alone, that they may be upheld and comforted, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our beloved dead and those who mourn their loss, that the mercy and love of God may envelop each one in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray especially for the eternal rest of Frank Lasak. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for our personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord. Almighty, ever-living God, who brings salvation to all and desire that not one should perish, hear the prayers of your people and grant that the course of our world may be directed by your peaceful rule and your church rejoice in tranquility and devotion. Through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this oblation, O Lord, we pray, cleanse and renew us, and may it become for those who do your will the source of eternal reward. Through Christ, our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, setting. Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. A new Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. I only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Having fed upon these heavenly delights, we pray, O Lord, that we may always long for that food by which we truly live. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.